When a male honeybee mates with a queen, his abdomen bursts open. This is quite a buzzkill for him, but it's not a problem for the queen because she goes on to mate with other enthusiastic party poppers to gather genes for her hive. But I can't help but wonder, what if the queen's first mate didn't die? Let's imagine he has an abdomen of steel or something. Could he, alongside the queen, be a king bee? Hi, I'm Cameron, and this is Minute Earth. The queen bee isn't a queen in the sense that she makes rules. She's a queen in the sense that she lays all of the eggs, which makes her the doted upon mother of all of the bees in the hive. And even though we are all familiar with the lone queen bee, many hive-dwelling species, like termites, also have kings who serve as the father of the entire hive. So it's not like there is no precedent for a king bee. But even with abs of steel, our hypothetical king is a non-starter, because bee genetics are bizarre. It starts out a lot like how humans, or termites for that matter, pass on their genes. Female bees put half of their complement of chromosomes in each egg. A male sperm contributes an equal number of chromosomes, and that fertilized egg with a full set of chromosomes becomes a baby. But here's where things get weird. Honeybee eggs can become baby bees even without a male's chromosomal contribution. The difference is that fertilized eggs, with two sets of chromosomes, which is a full complement of bee genes, develop into female bees, any of which could become a new queen under the right conditions, and unfertilized eggs with only one set of chromosomes become male bees. Male bees, in other words, only get genes from their mother. This weird genetic quirk means that a male bee can only have daughters, not sons. Of course, biological sex is complicated, and it's possible for honeybee eggs with two sets of chromosomes to be male, but they end up sterile, and the workers murder them as babies anyway. But even if we allow the king to only father daughters and potential new queens, a single male bee still couldn't father a hive's worth of them. Because he passes along all of his genes to each daughter, as opposed to half of them like the queen does, every daughter of his is super genetically related, which, if they all happen to inherit the same deadly mutation from their father, could be super disastrous for a hive with a single father. This genetic diversity issue is likely one reason, aside from all of the death, that the queen racks up a large body count. But I want to take this hypothetical exercise a tiny bit farther. What if having a full complement of chromosomes made a bee male and a half complement made a bee female? Keeping all else the same for the sake of our thought experiment, could we have a king bee then? Well, no. In this scenario, fertilized eggs would become males and unfertilized eggs would develop into females. But this doesn't improve things for our wannabe king. Here, males still only father one sex, males, and now there is an additional problem. In this hypothetical situation, female bees can produce daughters, again, any of which could become another queen, with no male contribution at all. Granted, they will run into the same genetic variation problems that a lone king would create, but ultimately, the male is completely irrelevant to the future of the hive here. So no matter how far we buzz down this hypothetical trail, we just can't make king bees work. A honeybee hive can only ever have a queen, and while she doesn't wear a crown, she's got a fabulous pair of mom jeans. A king bee will never rule a hive, so he's going to have to browse for some other options. It's a good thing he has the Opera browser to help, because Opera has a ton of features that make buzzing around the internet easier. All he has to do is ask a question, like, how do I start my own beehive? And Aria, Opera's AI feature, is ready with an answer. And even with Aria's help, his research might take him to tons of different web pages, so it's convenient that Opera has tab islands that allow our bee to group tabs however he likes, so his open pages never get lost. And those pages open fast, too, all thanks to Opera's built-in ad blocker. Opera also features a built-in VPN to keep his private information protected, and it even has messengers in the sidebar that let him keep in touch with all of his friends, if he has any. It's a tough world out there for a power-seeking bee, even one with abs of steel. You can download Opera from the link in the description. Thanks, Opera.